USP come up next and talk about some case studies. So with that, Larry, come up.
Hi, thank you. I lost a contact, and these glasses do some of the long distance, but up close they're horrible. So if you see me, I may need help reading stuff. So
we can read it.
Yeah. Well, I'm working with Karen on her project 0723, the access management in the vicinity of interchanges, and my part was to do some case studies. And the slide I was hoping to show you, let me see if I can go to the next one here. Oops. There we go. This is the site we're looking at, and the first slide provided a little information about it. This is a diamond interchange. I think it's in rural Arkansas. There's a town maybe about 3 miles away. It's very small. And as soon as you leave this immediate area where the freeway's adjacent here, it all goes to farmland. The diamond interchange has stop signs on the ramps. There's no frontage roads, and you can see the cross streets, only two lanes. And the alignment's sort of flat, but it's somewhat straight. It has an ADT of 12,000 vehicles per day. And the segment we're looking at from the ramp to the end of the last driveway is 612 feet. So we'll just be concentrating on that. On the north side, there's one side street and there's four drives. They're all commercial drives. And on the south side, there's also four commercial drives, and there's one roadway that actually goes to a cell tower. It's a driveway for the cell tower. We have crash data from 2010 to 2012, and per year there was 3.66 crashes. For a rate of 7.22 million vehicle miles of travel. And for fatal and injury, it was 0.66 crashes per year. So I think we described before what's out here. And we've numbered the drives, and we provided the little ruler at the bottom, so kind of see where we're at. Let's see if I can get this to go. Here is the crash data. What we did, we took the actual crashes that were out there, and we then ran the highway safety manual to see how the actual crashes would compare with average crashes on a light facility. The actual average number of crashes per year was 31.57, but when we ran the HSM, it came out to only 5.8. So you can see that in these areas where you've got a lot of people who are not familiar with the area, businesses coming in that you can pull in and make a lot of left turns and stuff, the crashes go way up. The fatal and injuries, the actual, was 16.39 when we look at crashes per mile per year. And the highway safety manual predicted 1.9. So we then went back and go to the next figure here. If funds, let's say, were unlimited and it was your desire to fix this up the best you could, I mean, without wiping out everything and starting fresh, what might you consider? And came up with a few recommendations. One would be on the off-ramp, and this isn't a geometric thing, but to put in the various businesses, the attractions, you know, where the food places are, you know, where they show whether it's a Wendy's or a McDonald's, and in what direction and how far it is, so that people once they do turn, they have some idea what they're looking for. They know what's available already. They're kind of thinking about maybe they made their choice while they were on the ramp. And so you don't get people stopping and starting and just slowing down and blocking some of the lanes. Also in here, all the drives, the widths range from 40 feet to 60 feet. And most of the businesses have multiple driveways. So we would look at trying to narrow those up. And in my state, it's 35 feet for the biggest driveway. So maybe something that or smaller if we could get it. Also, if you look at the driveways, if you look on the north side of the street and you look on the south side, you notice the driveways don't line up. So we've got just a series of offset intersections throughout this whole area where people making left turns from both the north side and the south side will conflict, you know, with the turn. So the ideally, it'd be nice to line those up. Also, this is a two-lane roadway, and for anybody wanting to turn left into either the north, there are no left turn lanes. So if a vehicle stops, they're going to block everybody behind them and hold them up. And when that happens sometimes, then people start making lefts further downstream out, and it just kind of, the through movements just go downhill. And last, there's the shoulders on this road are typically 6 feet, and when it comes time to resurface or to reconstruct a part of this, it'd be nice if the shoulders could be widened to 10 foot, and they can sort of be used then as right turn lanes if you couldn't get just regular dedicated right turn lanes out. So that's the first one. I have one other one if you want, if you have time. Again, I don't know if you can read this. It's not, let me go down and show you what it is here. This is a single point interchange, and we're looking at the area, as you look at it, to the left of the ramps. It is single control, and there are frontage roads. It's straight and flat. The ADT is pretty high. It's 39,800 per day. Speed limit of 40 miles per hour, and the segment length we'll look at down to the crossroad is 829 feet. On the north side, there's a major commercial driveway and one minor commercial driveway. And on the south side, there's a minor driveway, three major commercial driveways, and one side street. We didn't have any information on the signal frequency, but typically spoonies are three phase, so we would assume that. And then we do have the crash frequencies. From 2011 to 2013, there was 2.66 accidents per year, with the fatal and injury being 0.33. Here were the crashes, and none of the crashes occurred at intersections. They're all segment crashes. And again, if we want to compare these, we'll take the actual crashes that we had and compare them to what you would get if you ran the Highway Safety Manual. The actual crashes came out 51, and the Highway Safety Manual predicted 27.6, but when we looked at fatal and injury, they had 6.37, and the safety manual would have predicted a little higher, 8.6. It's still, these are averages, so they're still very close. So So then, like the other one, we looked at possible improvements that we can make. And you can sort of see it here. The first item would be 50% of all creations were angle creations involving left turners into or out of the businesses. We could put in a raised median that would stop them. And I'll talk a little bit if you're heading left off the diagram here. There's a way we can get you turned around. But probably, we've only got, I think, what is it, 800 feet to the interchange that block. You'd probably, if you made a right coming out, you'd probably have to go across the interchange and find a place to come back if you were to make a left turn to somewhere else in there. There are a number of left turn bays. If you're heading towards the left side of the page, there's two left turn bays to get into driveways on the south side, plus the left turn bay for the intersection, plus there's two left turn bays to get in for the north side of the road. Because of all the starting and stopping and getting into these places, And I believe you could use this for almost any place where you've got the crossroad. Just so close to the interchange, it doesn't function well. In here, if I can see, we're suggesting putting in a median U-turn intersection. The median U-turn intersection does a couple things. If the current intersection has left turn lanes on every approach, so that probably makes you have at least four signal phases where traffic on this crossroad would only move in one of the four. And that causes a lot of queuing, a lot of delay to come between the ramp and the intersection. If you go to the median U-turn, it's a two-phase signal. And typically, you'll get more green time, but you also cut down the cycling so you can come back to it very quickly compared to the four-phase. So if you want to make left turns then, you would make a right, and you can see we've put in some U-turns both towards the top of the page and the bottom on the other crossroad where we could spin you around and bring you back, and if you make a right, that's the equivalent of making the left. And I think that was it for this one. So those were the two. They said keep it short and standard 15 minutes. So
any questions for Larry?